Welcome friends, we will continue with differential indexing problems. Now the second example is given: obtain the indexing for 97 divisions and calculate indexing and change gears required. Available change gears same as 24 24, 2 gears 28 32 40 44 48 56 64 72 and 86. Index plates, as we know, plate number 1, plate number 2, plate number 3. Now, the given indexing is for 97 divisions. So, in all the plates, there is no whole circle for 97. So, it is difficult by simple indexing and compound indexing. So, that's why for a larger number, we will continue with a differential indexing with the help of a gear train mechanism. Now, the process is given as: first one, answer is in terms of the required 97 whole circle is not available in the index plate, so choose the nearest possible division. So, closer to 97, try to understand. I am not saying that by taking trial and error from this gear, but you can take any number which is closer to 97. So that whenever you are dividing to 40 by A, then you will get an appropriate indexing with simple crank moment. So, that's why I have chosen a closer number, that is A is equal to 100. Now, closer to 97, you can consider as number 80, you can consider as 110, you can consider it as a 94 or 96, or you can even consider 85 or 86. Any number closer, randomly you should choose closer to this 97. I have chosen it here as 100. So, what will be the indexing crank moment? 40 divided by assumed number. Assumed number is 100. 40 divided by 100, it will be 2 by 5. Now, this 2 by 5 will be multiplied by any number such a way that it should give me a whole circle from this plate number 1, 2, 3. Now, I have multiplied it by 4 by 5. So, I am getting it as 8 by 20. So, whether denominator 20 is available as a whole circle in these plates, just check. So, 20 is available here in plate number 1. You can multiply it by 5 into, you can take it as a 3 also. So, 3 by 3 if you multiply. So, it becomes 6 divided by 15. Then 6 divided by 15, 15 is a whole circle, plate number 1. So, any factor you can multiply so that the denominator should have a whole circle within these plates. So, the answer is 8 by 20. So, index crank has to move 8 holes in a 20 hole circle. But whatever indexing I am getting it is for assumed number of divisions to be made, that is 100. But this indexing is less than the required because you have to go for a 97 divisions. So, for that I have to go for additional gear train mechanism. So, for completing the indexing, second step is we need to find gear ratio. What is the formula of gear ratio? A minus N into 40 divided by A. So, where A is nearest possible division, that is 100, and number of divisions required is 97. So, A minus N, 100 minus 97, 40 by A, 40 divided by A is 100. So, it will be 3 into 2 by 5, you are getting 6 by 5. Now, this 6 by 5 is the gear ratio, but 6 and 5 number of teeth gears are not available in available change gears. See here, it is given as 24, 24 up to 86. So, 6 by 5 I should multiply with factor. So, I have multiplied it by 8 by 8. You can multiply by different number so that you should get those gear teeth in available gears. I am getting it as 48 and 40. As a driver and driven. But take care that these two gears must be available in the list of gears, that is 24 to 86, or otherwise your answer may go wrong. So, that's why multiply a factor or a number in such a fashion that the multiplication should come as available teeth of gears in the listed change gears. So, it is 48 by 40 driver upon driven. As your A minus N value is positive here and gear ratio you are getting it as a simple gear train. So, as per standards, no idler gear I am using, only simple gear train with 48 driver and 40 driven. Where should I attach this 48 and 40? See here, driver means to the spindle and driven means to the bevel gear. You can check it in this diagram also. So here, yes, here it is. So you can check it to the spindle. I will attach here a driver gear as a 48 number of teeth, and driven gear I will attach it as a 40 number of teeth at this position, so that it becomes your simple gear train. Now, further, here it is. For completing the indexing, I can write a statement as crank has to move 8 holes in a 20 hole circle in a forward direction, means in a clockwise direction, because A minus N is positive. And how many times I should proceed for this procedure? Same process I have to repeat 97 times with above gear ratio. So my indexing, initially I should go for a simple indexing, moving the crank by 8 holes in a 20 hole circle. That will transfer the motion to the spindle, and spindle will transmit the motion to this gear train, which is here calculated 48 by 40, and once again it gives motion to the index plate and crank, and accordingly your final job will be moved by one division. So such a process you should go for how many times? 97 times you should go, then you will get the same indexing. Hope so you understood this differential indexing. Now we will go for angular indexing. So what is angular indexing? It is setup is similar to simple indexing and very simple method. Only two formulas we have to use to solve this angular indexing. It must be calculated indexing with angular distance moved between divisions instead of number of divisions. As there are 360 degrees on a circle, so index crank is rotated by 40 number of revolutions. Spindle is to rotate one complete rotation. So on an index plate, number of whole circle provided it is 360 degrees. So 11 degree you can move, so that you are getting your job, you can move it for 1 degree. If I am moving the crank for 1 degree, your job will move by 1 degree. So you have large availability of how many times you can move. So 360 times you can move your crank. For each degree, you are getting each degree of moment as a job also. So once a complete turn of index crank turns will cause the spindle and the workpiece to rotate through 9 degrees, 360 divided by 40. So effectively you are getting it as a 9 degree. So if you are not understanding this procedure, you just focus on this formula. Indexing if you need in degrees, then formula will be number of degrees required divided by 9. So what is the meaning of this, that we will study. But try to understand, angular indexing is similar to simple indexing. So there are to no index, various index plates are provided, but we are dividing the index plate circle into total 360 degrees. So how, when a crank is rotated for one complete turn, then how many degrees will be indexed by the workpiece? Formula is given as 360 divided by 40 is equal to 9 degree. So meaning is what? If I rotate the index crank for one complete revolution on an index plate with any reference, then it will directly convert to rotate the job, or the workpiece will be indexed by 9 degrees. So indexing in the degrees, formula is number of degrees required divided by 9. So I will take one example so that you will understand. My formula is crank indexing in degrees will be angular displacement of job in degree divided by 9. Example is given. Suppose you want to calculate indexing for 45 degree. So your indexing will be, so angular displacement of job in degree is 45 degree and divided by 9 will be 5. So you have to turn the index crank for 5 times. Means simply if you go for a 5 turns, then you will get a 45 degree indexing. Calculate indexing for 60 degrees. So meaning is what? I am converting degrees into number of turns, so that I am getting the job indexing. Now if you want for 60 degree indexing, then formula is indexing is equal to angular displacement of job in degrees divided by 9. 60 divided by 9, I can write it in this term, 6 full turn 2 by 3. So 2 by 3 I will multiply it by 6. So 6 into 6 divided by 18, 6 पूर्णांक 12 छेद 18, so I am multiplying it by 6 by 6, so 6 full turn plus 12 holes on a 18 hole circle, so this is for 60 degree indexing. Keep in mind, I am not going for number of divisions now. Up till now, direct indexing, simple, compound or differential, I am going for number of divisions, but here I am going for degree. For 60 degree, my index crank, I should move for 6 full turn plus 12 holes in a 18 hole circle. Once I do this, I am getting immediately a 60 degree indexing on the job. So, not necessary to repeat it. Now, see here, this is crank indexing in minutes, angular displacement of a job in minutes divided by 540. Calculate the indexing for 24 degree 30 minute. I have written it here in terms of degree and minute. So, first of all, we must convert this degree into minutes. So, how I have converted? I have with me in minutes, formula is given as crank indexing in minutes, angular displacement of job in minutes divided by 540. So, I should convert this degree into minute, 24 into 60 degree into minute, 1440 minute. So, how many additional minutes are there? 30. So, 1440 plus 30, it will be 1470 minutes. Now, what I have done? I have with me 1470 total minutes. 24 degree converted to 1440 and additionally 30 minutes. So, 1470 minutes. So, put it in directly in this formula, not necessary to go by this step also. This step is not necessary. Directly go to this step. Crank indexing in minutes is equal to angular displacement of job in minutes divided by 540. How many total minutes are there? 1470 divided by 540. So, what you are getting? Here you are getting it as 2 full turn 13 divided by 18. Manje 2 purnanka 13 ched 18. Tar yacha meaning kay? So, you have to rotate the crank for 2 full turn and additionally 13 holes on a 18 hole circle. If you do this, then directly your job or indexing will done by 24 degree and 30 minute. I will go for second example so that you will understand easily. If you have suppose calculate indexing for 19 degree and 40 minute, then first of all, this degree must be converted into minute. So, overall unit must be in minutes. 90 degree into 60 minute, it is 1100 minute. Add 40 minute, you are getting 1180. So, this step is not required. Directly put it in this formula. Crank indexing is equal to angular displacement in job in minutes divided by 540. This formula is applicable for minutes and 9 degrees applicable for degree formula. So, two formulas you should remember. So, here divide this formula will becomes now angular displacement of job is 1180 divided by 540. You are getting 2 full turn 5 divided by 27. So, what is the answer? Your crank must be rotated for 2 full turn and 5 holes on a 27 hole circle. If you do this with crank this rotation, then you are indexing your job for 19 degree 40 minute. So, you have only two formulas. One formula is for degree, converting degree into rotation. This is one, that is angular displacement of job in degree divided by n. That is 9 divided by 9. This is one formula. And second formula is with you that angular crank indexing in minutes is equal to angular displacement of job in minutes divided by 540. So, this degree is converted into minutes. So, we will add 30 minutes, you are getting total minutes divided by 540. If it is minutes, divide it by 540. If it is in degree, divide it by 9. So, you are getting it answer as divide 1470 divided by 540, you are getting answer 2 full turn 13 divided by 18. Your answer must be 2 full turn and 13 holes on an 18 hole circle. So, with this crank moment, you are getting the indexing of job for how many? 24 degree and 30 minute. So, this much accuracy in degree and minutes you can carry out in only angular indexing. It is not possible in the simple or compound or differential indexing. So, this is the last indexing mechanism. So, hope so you are understanding these methods. If you have any doubts, you can give the feedback and tell me the indexing the assignment you go